हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी आर डूइंग स्टैंडर्ड 10 मैथ्स चैप्टर नंबर 5 अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। वी आर ऑलमोस्ट टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ द चैप्टर। इन द लास्ट पीरियड वी हैव टेकन सर्टेन क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज नंबर 5.3। नाउ टुडे द लास्ट 6 क्वेश्चंस विच आर ऑफ द टाइप प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम्स वी आर टेकिंग टुडे, एंड टुडे वी विल कंप्लीट अवर चैप्टर, दिस चैप्टर नंबर 5। सो आई टेक the first question among last 6 questions of exercise number 5.3. I tell you the story of the question. One contract on the construction job, the contract was decided that if the delay in work is done, if there is delay in the completion of the work is done, then there is certain penalty to be charged. So if the delay is by one day for the completion of the work, the penalty will be rupees 200. So I write, first day, delay by the first day, the penalty is rupees 200. Suppose delay is for 2 days, so the penalty for the second day is rupees 250. Suppose delay is for the 3 days, then the penalty for the third day is rupees 300. That way it goes on. Now suppose the contractor delays the work by 30 days, then how much amount as a penalty he will have to pay? So delay by 30, that means this is the AP, 200, 250, 300, 350, so on, and up till 30th term, this figure goes on as the AP. So we want to find out ultimately total penalty to be paid by the contractor if he delays the work by 30 days. Okay, so ultimately S30 you want to find out. I write the formula first. Sn is equal to n by 2 into bracket 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Sn is how much? We want to find out how many terms. There are 30 days, so 30 is the term, 30 upon 2. So ultimately you want to find out S30. 30 by 2 into bracket 2a, 200 2s are 400, plus 30 is n, so 30 minus 1, 29, and difference is 250 minus 200, 50. Only simple calculation is left. It is 15, 400 plus 0, is that is 9 5s are 45, 4 carry, 5 2s are 10 and 4, 14. So it is 15 into bracket 1450 plus 400, so it is 1850. So now the product of these two numbers will be your answer. So I do it here, 1850 multiplied by 15. 5 zeros are 0, 5 5s are 25, 2 carry, 8 5s are 40 and 2, 42, 4 carry, 5 1s are 5 and 4, 9. 1 zeros are 0, 1 5s are 5, 1 8s are 8 and 1 1s are 1. 0, 5, 5 and 2, 7, 9 and 8, 17, 1 carry, 1 and 1, 2. So total penalty is rupees 27,750 if the work is delayed by 30 days. Is it clear? We go for the next. So ultimately in this practical problem, you have to derive the values and you have to find the AP first of all out of it and then calculate it. We take the second question. Rupees 700 is to be distributed as the prizes in the school, and prizes are 7. Total amount is to be distributed rupees 700, and it is said that each prize reduces by rupees 20. Okay, so 7 prizes. So I write here n is equal to 7. S7, that is Sn, is given 700 and each price reduces by 20 rupees, so difference is equal to 20. Okay, so now what are the values of all the seven prices that you want to find out? So we take it this way. I plot the formula for Sn. Sn is equal to n by 2 into bracket 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, and it is said that the 700 are the total amount, seven prices are there, and each price reduces by rupees 20. So you have to find out all these seven. So what is Sn? 700. How many terms? 7. So 7 by 2 into bracket 2 times A plus N is 7. 7 minus 1, 6, and difference is 20. Okay? So you can check here, 700 multiplied by 2 upon 7 is equal to 2A plus 6 to the 12, so it is 120. 700 is 700, so 200, 100 to the 200 minus 120 is equal to 2A. So 200 minus 120, 80 is equal to 2A. So A is equal to 80 upon 2 is 40. So first term is 40 of the AP. Okay? Now every price reduces by rupees 20. So if I take 40 first, I add 20 to it, 60. Next is 80 plus 20, 100 plus 20, 120 plus 20, 140 plus 20, 160. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 prices. Now if you take the sum of all these numbers, it should come to 700. Let us check. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So first is 0. Second digit, 10th place. 6 and 4, 10. 10 and 2, 12. 12 and 8, 20. 20 and 6, 26 and 4, 30 is a 0. 3 carry 4. 3 and 1, 4. And 1, 5. And 1, 6. And 1, 7. Okay? So these are the 7 prices which differ by rupees 20. Okay? Now we take the third question. All questions are easy, only to understand it properly, that is important. Now in the school, there was a tree plantation program. Now what is the planning? Each section of each class will plant trees equal to the class. That means, suppose class means standard. Standard one, okay? So suppose there are three sections, A, B, and C, then every section will have to plant three plants, three trees. In the same way, standard two, all classes have three sections, but at standard two, every section will plant two plants. Standard three, again three sections. So as in standard three, they will plant three. That way we have to go up till standard 12. Again three division. So as standard is 12, it is 12 and 12 plants. Did you understand? It is the story. Then in this tree plantation, what will be the total number of trees planted? Means we want to find out S, sum. How many terms are there? 12. So I go for, first of all, I form AP. First term, standard 1, 1 plus 1, 3. Standard second, 2 plus 2, 6. Standard third, 3 plus 3, 9. You can check the difference of 3 is occurring. So lastly, standard 12 means 36. So this is your AP. Now only you have to find out, there are 12 terms, so go for Sn. Sn is equal to n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Sn you want to find out, how many terms are there? 12. 12 upon 2, that is 6. 2 times a, so 3 into 2, 6, plus n minus 1 means 12 minus 1, 11, and difference is 6 minus 3, 3. Okay? So 6 into 6 plus 11 3 is 33. So 6 multiplied 33 plus 6, 39. Now take the product. 9 6 is 54. 5 carry forward. 6 3 is 18. 18 and 5, 23. So total number of trees planted on that tree plantation day is 234 trees. Is it clear? We go for the next question. It is very good question. Spiral. Spiral means what? It is called spiral. So spiral is made alternately with center A and center B. It is point A, it is point B. The distance between A and B is 0.5 centimeter. Okay? Now, first spiral, spiral number 1 is of radius 0.5 with A center. So now, A is the center and radius is 0.5 means AB. So this will be your first spiral, suppose ending at point C. So now radius 1 is 0.5. Now second spiral, it is with center B now. So B center and 0.5 plus 0.5, 1. So 1 will be the radius. Okay? So now B center and BC radius. So this will be the second spiral. Suppose ending at D. So it is center A, it is center B. Now again center A. Alternately with A and B, the semicircles are made. Now center A and AD radius, so it is 0.5 and it is 1. So now radius 3 is 1.5. So now A center, AD radius. So it will be somewhat like this, ending at E. Okay, this way the spiral continues. So there are certain 13 semicircles are to be drawn or are to be made alternately, one with center A and second with center B. Okay, so what is the total length of this 13 semicircle? That is our question. So first of all, I make the AP. Length of the semicircle is what? Pi r. So first radius is 0.5. So 0.5 pi is your first. Second is 1 pi. Third is 1.5 pi. Fourth is 2 pi. That way you have to go for 13th term. Up till 13th term, you have to write this AP. And you want to find out the total length of all these 13 semicircles. So I go for Sn. N by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. S 13. So it is 13 upon 2. What is first term? 0.5 pi into 2. 0.5 2 is 1. 1 into pi is pi. Plus n minus 1. 13 minus 1, 12. And difference is what? 1 pi minus 0.5 pi means it is 0.5 pi. Or I can say half pi. It is the difference. Okay? Now 13 upon 2 pi plus 2 6 are 12. So it is 6 pi. 13 upon 2, 1 pi plus 6 pi, it is 7 pi. Now you know what is the value of pi. So accordingly, 13 upon 2 into bracket 7 multiplied. Value of pi is 22 upon 7. 7, 7 cancel, 2 ones are 2, 11 twos are 22. So it is 13 into 11. So if you multiply 13 times are 130 plus 30, 13 is equal to 143 centimeters. So total length of these 13 semicircles, if the spiral is formed so, is 143 centimeters. Is it clear? We go for next. you are familiar with the logs. Logs of the wood means like this they are. Okay, one log, then it is second log, then third log. That way the logs are kept. What is the pattern of the logs? Did I tell you? First of all, there are total 200 logs. So, number of logs, that is SN, is equal to 200, total number of logs. They are in this way. Suppose it is bottom row, then top to it, then top to it, then top to it. That way the logs are arranged. It is given that on the bottom row there are 20 logs, above it 19, above it 18. So how many such rows will be there? That is N I want to find out. Your first term A is 20. Okay? So how many rows are there if they are stacked like this? And second thing, what is the number of logs in the first column? So you want to find out N and you want to find out A also, or the last term also. Okay? So we directly plot the formula. SN is equal to N by 2 into bracket 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Okay? SN is what? 200. How many rows are there? I don't know. So it is N by 2. 2A, I take 20 as the first term. So 2 into 20, 40 plus N minus 1. Difference is 19 minus 20. 18 minus 19 is minus 1. So 200 2's are 400 is equal to N into bracket 400 minus N plus 1. Okay? So 400 is equal to N into bracket 401 minus N. So 400 is equal to 401N minus N square. Okay? So I think there is one mistake. Let me check it once more. Difference is minus 1. First is not 400, it is 40. 22 is a 40. It was the mistake. So it is 41. Okay? Okay, I repeat, first row is 20, so 22 is 40, and I simplified this, so 40 plus 1, 41 minus N, so 41N minus N square. I bring it on the right hand side, N square minus 41N plus 400 is equal to 0. Now you have to solve this, you have to split the equation degree 2 and finally get the answer, or well, get the value of N. So what is the splitting of 400? If you factorize 400 in the prime factor method, you will get 25 16s. So N square minus 25N minus 16N plus 400 is equal to 0. So N common, N minus 25 minus 16 common, N minus 25 is equal to 0. So N minus 25 into N minus 16 is equal to 0. So N is equal to 25, or N is equal to 16. Now two different numbers we are getting. There can be 25 rows, or then can be 16 rows. So any one is wrong. So how to check it? We find A25. First of all, select that number of rows is 25. So 25 is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So A25 is equal to A plus 25 minus 1, 24. Difference is minus 1. So A plus 24 minus. And your first row is 20, you know. So answer is 24. So sorry, 4. So minus 4 is not possible as the answer. So 25 we cannot take, as the number of rows. So answer is 16. So there are 16 is the total number of rows. And finally, if you plot the value of 16 for n, you can get what is the value of a. So if you simplify, you will get a is equal to 4. I leave it to you because I think we are short of time and we have to still complete one more question. So get the value of a that way, okay? And the last question we take. There is a potato race in the school. One bucket is kept here. From the bucket, it is the starting point. One potato is kept at a distance of 5 meters. Then it is first potato. More 9 potatoes are kept. And now they are at distance of 3 meters each. Okay? So total number of potatoes are 10. Now what the participant has to do? He will start from the beginning, take the potato after running 5 meters, pick it up, come back to here and keep the potato in the bucket. So for the first time, the runner will go for 5 plus 5, 10 meters. It is your first term of the AP. Now, again from here, he will go up till here. So 5 plus 3, 8. Again, come to beginning. So 8 plus 8, 16. For the third time, 5 plus 3 plus 3. 5 and 3, 8 and 3, 11. 11 for going, 11 for coming. So it is 11 to the 22. This way it will go. And how many potatoes are there? 10. So up till 10th term, she will run the distance respectively 10, 16, 22, so on. Okay? So what is the total distance covered by the participant that you want to find out? So we know there are 10 terms. So S10 is equal to 10 by 2 into bracket 2A. So 10 to the 20 plus N minus 1, 10 minus 1, 9 into difference. 16 minus 10, that is 6. So 10 upon 2 is 5. 20 plus 9, 6 are 54. So 5 into 20 plus 54, it is 74. Now 74 5s are. 5 4s are 20, 2 carry forward, 7 5s are 35 into 37. So ultimately, total distance covered by the runner or the participant is 370 meters. Okay? So this is how very easily you can solve the particular problems. So here we come to the end of this chapter number 5. So please read it properly. Try to do the exercise in your notebook, complete your notebook. And if any problem, you can ask me on the given number. Thank you very much.